Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to the global audience assembled today. Welcome to another episode of the Turing Boundaryless Podcast. I'm your host, Krishna Vinod, social media head at Turing. And I'd like everyone to put their hands together for a very special guest. Today, I have with me Zan Doan, the SVP of Engineering at Turing. He has 10 plus years of experience in entrepreneurial and leadership roles. He leads a talented team of globally distributed engineers that help build Turing's vetting, matching, and customer success products. Zan was an engineering manager at Facebook prior to this, where he led a team of 20 engineers to build advertising platforms that serve 100 million Facebook advertisers and have $8 billion in annual revenue. So first of all, welcome to the show, Zan. Where are you based out of?
Hi, Krishna. Hi, everyone. I located in Newark, California, in the east side of the Bay Area, very close to Facebook headquarters.
Awesome. So I think there's roughly some 12,000 kilometers distance between us. I'm based out of Gurgaon, India. Zan, welcome to our podcast. Tell us a bit more about your story and how you reached this point in your career as the SVP of Engineering, leading such a talented team of globally distributed engineers at Turing.
That's a great question. So I've been asked many times that why you decided to leave Facebook and why did you join Turing. So for the main reasons, I work in a couple of startups in the past related to recruiting, education, fintechs, cryptocurrency. So I like to work in a startup environment to build a team from scratch to spread my impact to the whole company. After joining Facebook for 5 years, I decided to continue working in a fast scaling startup. So I just look around the company in the markets. And Turing attracted me by its mission and vision. And at Turing, then we have the opportunity to work with the talents all around the world and help a lot of software engineers to grow their career and connect with US companies.
Awesome. That's very interesting, Zan. And I'm going to use that for my next question. So you mentioned you were able to work with, you know, these amazing talents, amazing engineers from around the world. How do you define a good engineer?
That's a great but also tricky question. Because when we talk about a good engineer, then we have different level and different criteria. For example, a junior engineer needs to be strong in technical skill, only like writing codes, debug the codes daily. While for senior engineers, we have a higher expectation for them in technical communication and leadership skills. So in general, I think there are three things a good engineer should have. One is proactive. The second thing is strong in communication skill, because communication play a very important role, especially in this time where people work remotely. And the other things, of course, they need to be strong in technical skill, in programming skill, CS, fundamental soft skill as well.
Awesome. That's very, very interesting. So Zan, Turing is known for its great developers, right? How are you and how is Turing using automation and technology to vet and match the best developers from around the globe?
Yes, when we vet engineers at Turing, we need to think about it in scale, because we need to interview hundreds of thousands developers per month in the system. So how can we do that effectively why certain maintain the high qualities for the interviews. So to do that, we had to implement automation and also AIs to vet and match the best engineers around the world with US companies. And then in vetting, we divided the flow into four different steps. And for each step, then we implement automation to automate the assessment for developers. So we have the automated test for computer science fundamentals. And then after that, developer can take the automated test for technologies where we test them for a specific skill like C++, Python, PHP. We also have an assessment in soft skill as well. Of course, it's an automated flow with a lot of adaptive questions, single choice, multi-choice. And we also bring the engineer into the automated coding challenge, where we test them the real-time coding and debugging skill. So after all the automated tests, the developers will be moved to the matching flow. And then in the matching flow, we also need to implement automation because we have to match hundreds of thousands developers for the jobs monthly. And then how can we do that? We develop an automated matching algorithm that automatically recommends the best candidates for each job. And then after that, then we move them to the next steps in negotiation, setting up interviews with the customer, and then sign the contract with them. So the step also automated by the matching flow. And so that's why we can handle hundreds of thousands matches per month.
Wow. That's honestly incredible, handling such a large number of incoming developers. But so that's amazing. So Zan, for an engineering leader, according to you, what's the most important thing that they need to keep in mind while hiring developers?
Yeah, Krishna, as I mentioned before, then proactive is the key. Mm-hmm. And I can divide it into smaller categories. So the first thing is the discipline. Discipline is very important, especially when we work with remote engineer. So they need to maintain the regular schedule and also follow the instruction come from people around the team. That's a very important thing that I expect from the engineer that I work with. The second thing is a high availability. So we want to have a decent overlap the time, the working hours with the engineer, and regular update from them. Because it's also hard for us to work with people from like 5,000 miles away, right? So we need to sync with them regularly and have a fast response in communication. Yeah, the third thing is to know how to unblock themselves. So this also is one important thing when the engineers working with remote customer, because we only have a few hours of the day to sync and discuss directly with the other people in the team. And besides that, then we will spend more time in independent work. So the engineer need to ping the right people.
That's a great point, Zan. I mean, I think all of those points are very important, but especially knowing how to unblock yourself, I think that's the most important skill for any employee or any engineer. Zan, now, again, another question, from an engineering leader viewpoint, how should one look at hiring remote engineers and vetting them for a Silicon Valley standard?
Yeah, so to vet engineers for Silicon Valley standards, then we of course need to ask them a standard Silicon Valley interview questions, like what Microsoft asks them. But how to do that in a scale? Because we don't have a very big recruiting teams like in Google's or other tech giants in the Bay. And also we don't want to do that. We want to use products to do that in a scale. So as I mentioned above, we have automated tests with thousands of interview signals to hire remote engineers based on four important categories. One is the background in computer science. The second thing is the technology skill. Third thing is the soft skill with communication, collaboration. And the fourth thing is the coding, programming skill. So the way we hire remote engineer is actually similar to the standards that Google or other tech giant in the Bay Area using. But we convert the content into automated tests with adaptive questions, with single choice, multi-choice questions. So we can know the results immediately after the engineer takes the test.
Awesome, Zan. That's very, very interesting. Now a question from the developer's viewpoint. So Zan, what would be the best practices that a developer can follow for working with American customers?
Yeah, so I can see the common way that remote developers fail when they work with American customers, like they're not proactive enough, or because of the culture difference, so they was very silent in the working space. So I would recommend the remote engineer to be proactive in communication. So some case studies, they can double check with the customer to clearly understand the requirement of the task, can have the daily updates with the customer. 5 minutes per day is okay, but they should let the customer know what I have done so far, what I gonna work in the workdays, and what's blocking me. So the customer can also help them, unblock them if necessary. And third thing is feel free to ask for help. One common case for remote developers, they try to solve the problem themselves and stuck for few days and a week, and they don't let anyone know about their current situation. So I would recommend if the developer stuck, feel free to ask for help from the manager, from the teammates to unblock themselves. Also, it's not hard to ask for help, and the ways we get by the end of the day, how much impact you contribute. We don't care how many questions you ask people. So don't be afraid.
Wow. So developers listening in, I hope you're taking notes. I mean, that's very valuable advice. Don't be afraid to ask for help. Make sure you get your requirements very clearly and make sure to stay in constant touch with your managers and make sure that they are apprised of what you're working on. Thanks a lot, Zan. Thanks for joining us. This was very insightful. I hope engineering leaders as well as developers would be able to benefit from this. I'd also like to thank everyone else who joined us today. Please show this video some love. Give it a big thumbs up. Share it with your friends. Tell us more about what you would like us to cover in the next video in the comment section. You can also subscribe to Turing on your preferred social media or podcast for more such content. We are available on all major platforms. We'll see you again in the next Boundaryless podcast. Thank you for joining us.